In this video, I'll talk about the basic structure of an atom. And an atom can be thought of as the basic unit of an element. And that is the element, like an element, gold or copper or oxygen. It's the atom is the basic unit of that, the building block of each of those elements. So I'll write that down, basic unit of an element. And then we can, it turns out, break the atom up into subatomic particles. And that's what I'm going to talk about in this video, the basic particles of the proton, the neutron, and the electron. So the way this is usually described is we have this nucleus consisting of protons and neutrons. I'll put in this atom, I'll put two protons and I'll put two neutrons. So I've got the protons in blue and the neutrons in red. This would actually be maybe a helium. This is a helium atom. So this is the nucleus right here, consisting of the protons and the neutrons, the center of the atom. And then out here in this cloud, or orbital shells, sometimes they're called, you have these electrons residing. And in most cases, if this is a balanced atom, it doesn't have any charge on it, then we would have an equal number of electrons as we do protons. So I'll put those in. I'll just put two electrons. So in purple, I have electrons. Now, the electrons are tiny compared to the proton and the neutron, but this space in between the nucleus and where the electrons reside is really big relative to the nucleus. So, for example, the size of the atom is 200 picometers. That's the diameter, or the distance across one atom, is roughly 200 picometers. And I should let you know that one picometer, this tiny unit of measure, is 1 times 10 to the negative 12th meters. Okay, so I could rewrite that then as 2 times 10 to the negative 10th meters. 2 times 10 to the negative 10th meters across an atom. Or you could describe it as, if going the other way, if I had all of these atoms lined up. So what I'm drawing now is these atoms back to back, touching each other and spanning just 1 millimeter, just 1/1000th of a meter. So, but we can, it's tiny, but we can visualize 1 millimeter, just a little bit thicker than the pencil lead in your mechanical pencil. So that's 1 millimeter. Well, to span that distance, it would take 5 million atoms. 5 million atoms, just to span 1 millimeter. So that's the size, the tiny size of an atom. But coming back to this, I was talking about this giant space relative to the nucleus. There's a huge amount of space between the nucleus and where the electrons reside. And that is because the nucleus is smaller yet. So if I want to talk about just the nucleus, well, the distance across the nucleus, whereas the entire atom is 2 times 10 to the negative 10th meters across, the nucleus would be about 1 times 10 to the negative 14th meters across. Or put in another way, if I had this nucleus, these protons and these neutrons, this nucleus here, and if I said this nucleus is just 1 centimeter across, if I blew this up, we know it's really tiny, but if I blew it up so that it was just 1 centimeter across, then that would make the the orbit, or I should say the orbital shells of the electrons, so big that they would span, the size of the atom would span two football fields. So that is just gigantic. So I'll put the gridiron here, and I better put some goalposts so we know that it is a football field. And I've only drawn one of them. That's only half the atom. So I would have to draw another one to get to the size of the atom relative to the size of the tiny nucleus. So another one. Now, if you would like to say, well, hey, what if the nucleus was the size of a football? Speaking of football, well, multiply that football, the size of the football, by 20,000, and that'll give you the size, the relative size of the atom. So there's a lot of space in between the nucleus and the tiny electrons. Let's talk about what makes up the nucleus, the protons and the neutrons. Color coding here, I've got the protons in blue. A proton is positively charged, and it offsets the negative charge of the electron. So a proton has a positive charge. The neutron, which might make you think of the word neutral, has no charge. It is a neutral charge, or no charge. Each of these, if you were to weigh these, well, you would weigh a weight, but you would determine a mass. If you talk about the mass of each of these, the neutron is just a tiny bit more. It's a little bit more massive than the proton, has a little bit more mass, but rounding to just the digits, I'll give you 1.67 times 10 to the negative 24th. They're very close in mass, grams. So still very, very small in mass. 1.67 times 10 to the negative 24th grams. So take this decimal point and move it back to the left 24 places. The electron. I told you that the electron has a negative charge. Staying with our color coding here, the electron is negatively charged. It turns out, according to what we know today, as of this writing, the charge of the proton and the charge of the electron are the same. And the reason I say according to what we know now is because if you look at the history of chemistry, well, models of the atom have changed over time, even just in the last 200 years. And so you know, we don't have all the answers. And we like to think that we do, but we don't. But we're getting closer and closer. And this is a very good model. It's the best model that we have today. And so we say that the charges are exactly the same. The proton and the neutron have this mass. I'll tell you the mass of the electron. I said it's a lot smaller. The mass of the electron is about 9.11 times 10 to the negative 28th grams. So the mass of the proton is over 1,800 times the mass of the electron. And the neutron is just a tiny bit bigger than that. According to this decimal, I've rounded it so that they look the same. But the neutron is just a tiny bit more massive than the proton. So that's it in a nutshell, the basic building blocks. There are other subatomic particles in an atom, but this is what we're concerned with in chemistry, is the proton, the neutron, and the electron. Now, if you found this video helpful, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.